We are going to visit Brazil and we are going to explore all the zoos, airports, and amusement park of Brazil. The pilot for the today's flight is Tarika, and the co-pilot for the today's flight is Rashleen, along with the crew member Akansha. Over to you, Rashleen.
Good afternoon, all the guests. So, are we all start with this tour?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. First, we will know about Brazil. Some short introduction about the Brazil. It is an official Federal Republic of Brazil and the largest country in both the South America and Latin America, which covers the area of 8,5,567 square kilometers, with a population of mainly 201 million people. Brazil is the world's fifth largest and the sixth most populous country, composed 26 states and the federal district. It is the largest country of Portuguese, has an official language, and the one of the world's most multicultural and the ethical diverse nation. Due to over a century of mass immigration from around the world, it is also the most populous Roman Catholic majority country, and capital is Brasilia, while the largest city is São Paulo. What is Brazil famous for? Brazil is famous for its iconic carnival festival and its talented soccer players like Pele and Neymar. Brazil is also known for its tropical beaches, aquatic waterfalls, and the Amazon rainforest. The president of the Brazil is Jair Bolsonaro trending. In the capital, we all know Brasilia. The currency of the Brazil is Brazilian real. Now, next slide, please. Now we're gonna learn the sixth biggest amusement parks of Brazil. Next slide. First, Beto Carrero World. It's the Latin American's largest theme park, which is located in the city of Penha. In the state of Santa Catarina, among them are the main event like free fall toy, the free whip, the only inverted roller coaster of Brazil, and the supercars. There are many things, like the park is also famous for its world-class performance. The park is mainly divided among seven distinct areas with their own individual themes. Now, we will look at some of the attractions of these parks. It has the Nation Castle, which occupies 10,444 meters square of area, which contain the ticket office, the new railroad, the stores, the cafe, the lockers, and the more services. It has the baby elephant area, which shows the elephant area and the famous baby elephant. It has a paddle boat, which is a ride on the lake next to the Pirate Island. It is also have the adventures of Bento Carrero 4D, a 4D cinema, and ice cream palace, which also include the food court, the event hall, and the Ferris wheel. Ferris wheel, what is Ferris wheel? Ferris wheel is about 25 meters in the height. It has water show and the boat ride and the small world. Next slide, please. Now we will gonna learn about the Hopi Hari. It is the one of the largest parks in the country. Hopi Hari has the fifth largest roller coaster in the world called Montezum. It's located in the city of Vinhedo, in the countryside of state of São Paulo. Tourists walk around different landscapes from the world old American west to Europe glamour. The attraction area is the Lake Volga. This is the 69 meter tall, means 226 feet, Italian giant drop. Upon reaching the top of the tower, the gondolas are held up for the 2 minutes and then released, reaching speeds of 85 km per hour in just 4 seconds. On February 24, 2012, a 14-year-old girl is invented this with the attractions over this park, Hopi Hari, which we call. The next slide, please. Now we will gonna learn about the beach park. Beach park is close to the capital of the state of Ceará, Fortaleza. It's the largest water park of Brazil, set on the seafront in the city of Aquarius. There are 16 attractions. So the most radial one is the water slide with 41 meter tall. In the complex, there are also resorts for lodging. It is constructed in 1989. The Inferno previously held the Guinness Book of World Record for world tallest water slide at 135 feet tall. There's more thing. It is the largest epipus, the latest addition to the beach park complex. It is the collection of pro slide water slides that features the first skybox in Brazil. Next slide, please. Now we will see about the hot park. Hot park, it is situated in the city of Rio Quinto in the state of Goiás. Hot park is famous for its natural hot waters. Among the attractions, it has the water park. There are swimming pools, including one with waves. 3 climbing, zip line climbing, abseiling, ecological scuba diving, and even surfing lessons for children. Next slide, please. Snowland. It is the winter theme park with an alpine style village and an indoor snow-covered hill for skiing and tubing. It's the first indoor snow park of the Americas, established on 25th October 2013. With the 16 kilometers capacity for up to 1,000 people and up to 3,500 visits per day. The snowy mountain, where you can sky the practice snowboard, and the alpine village, an environment with the electronic toys reminiscent of the Swiss valleys, are some of the most amazing attractions. Next slide, please. Now we will see Termas de Laranjeiras. It is the park whose complex is situated in Olympia, Sao Paulo, divided at attractions by categories: radials for children, for seniors, and for the family. With the aquatic complex, the tourist head and your disposal 2 beaches, leisure and tourism areas with shop, restaurant, bars, among other. The park has the perfect water temperature and plenty of different pools, rides, and attractions. Fun for all the family. Best place to go with kids. This ticket grants you access to more than 50 attractions, including water slides, wave pools, thermal spring pools, and the saunas. The park is also surrounded by naturally protected valley and offers area to catch sight of local wildlife. Now we will gonna look about some amazing videos. Can we have a video, please?
Okay, we have some more videos on the amusement parks. So let me share the videos, then we will go with the PPT.
So you all enjoyed the world of amusement park?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. Now we will look at the Zoo of Brazil. Next slide, please. Our first zoo is Zoo das Aves. It is the English, in English, we can say it is a bird park. It is a sanctuary and shelter of birds situated in Foz do Rio Parque State, Brazil. And it is near to Lafayette Fall. It exhibits, comprises mainly birds as well as other animals and butterflies. The park was opened in 1994. And it is a set within the 16 hectares, which is 40 acres of forest. With more than 800,000 visitors every year, Parc des Ves become a very popular destination for many people visiting Foz do Rio, including more than 35,000 school children. The people of the bird park claim to work for a better world, and they say that they have created a place where people can live in peace with nature. They also want to save species from the brink of extinction. Next slide, please. Now we will learn about the Parque Zoológico Municipal Conde Barros. It is the 15th hectare zoo located in the municipality of Sorocaba, state of Sao Paulo, Brazil. It is a member of the Society of Brazilian Zoos and is considered Brazilian's second zoo in terms of species. The zoo lies in the Vila Votorantim district, is the eastern area which covers 15 hectares, like 37 acres of the forest, includes a strip of transition Atlantic forest and the lake, as well as historical museum of Sorocaba. Next slide, please. Next is Projeto Tamar. The Projeto Tamar is the Brazilian non-profit organization owned by the Chico Mendes Institute for the Biodiversity Conservation. The main objective of the project is to protect sea turtle from extinction in the Brazilian coastline. Brazilian initiate protects 40 million sea turtles. We will know more about Tamar. The Tamar project is created in 1980 and it is internationally hailed as the one world's most successful experience in sea conservation. They are the role model for initiative in both Brazil and the other countries because it directly involves coastal communities and it is mainly for the conservation of sea turtles. It is the conservation efforts and research about the turtles which are going to be extinct. Tamar was with the first syllabus is Targuna Marina. It is a sea turtle. Sea turtle name is Tardeguna marina. It comes from reference to the conservation of sea turtles in Brazil. Next slide, please. This is Zoo Pomerado. It is the conversation focused on zoo with around 250 species of native and exotic mammals, birds, and reptiles. Visit Zoo Pomerado, the first zoo established in southern Brazil. The zoo covers 3.5 hectares, which is 8.6 acres of developed space, with another area double that size, which earmarked for future expansions. This is the small zoo, has a log pocket into it. It is toting more than 1,100 animals, representing more than 220 different species. Many of the species is there, which is in the located in the area of the biggest areas. The main focus of this zoo is to the reproductions of such species and the conservations. It aims to raise awareness and educate children since 2002. Be sure to visit the birds, with some of them even flying overhead, and the entertaining monkeys. The zoo includes a parking lot, cafeteria with drinks and snacks, a visitor center, a shop, and an environmental education center where you can attend lectures and group activities. So now we will gonna look some more videos upon the Zoo of Brazil. Videos, please. So we have gained a lot of knowledge about the Brazil Zoo and amusement park. Now it's time to gain some little knowledge about the airports in Brazil. Let's enter to the world of the airports which are there in Brazil and explore them. Next slide, please. The first airport which we're gonna see and learn about is Egua Boa. It is in the city of Brazilian, which is the capital, and it is a state of Mato Grosso. In 2020, its population was established to be in 13,523. Next slide, please. Now, it is the next airport is Gurualoz International Airport. It is the primary international airport serving São Paulo. It's a popularly known as the either Quebec Airport or after the district where it is located. It has the still exist at the airport complex or the Garden Airport. The São Paulo metropolitan area, where it's located since November 28, 2001. The airport has been named after André Francisco Montero, 1916 and 1999, former governor of São Paulo state. The airport was rebranded as a GRU airport in 2012. Next slide, please. Next is Congonhas Airport. It is the one of the four commercial airports serving Sao Paulo, Brazil. Congonhas has lot restrictions, operating with the maximum of 30 operations per hour. Being one of the five airports with such restrictions in the Brazil. In 2019, it was the second busiest airport in the Brazil by passenger traffic after Sao Paulo, Guarulhos. Next slide, please. Next, which we're going to learn is Presidente Gustavo Kubitschek International Airport. It is the only international airport serving Brasilia. The airport was named after Juscelio Kubitschek, 1902-1976, the 21st president of Brazil. It is located in the administrative region of Lago Sul in the Frederick district. Some of its facilities are shared by the Brazilian Air Force. It is operated by Inframerica. Now we'll see some videos. Okay, sorry. The last is Galeno International Airport, popularly known by its original name. Galeno International Airport is the main airport serving Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. In 2019, it was the country's fourth busiest airport by passenger traffic. It is named after the neighbor of Galeno. Now we'll see some videos.
Nice.
Okay, nice. So for tomorrow, we are going to visit Canada.
Canada.
Yes. So anyone of you knows the wildlife of Canada?
No, ma'am.
I know one.
I admit that it's very cold.
Yes.
I know one.
Okay, tell.
The Canada geese.
And ma'am, there are many polar bears.
Yes, because it's cold. The
capital is Ottawa.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
And currency is the dollars.
Yes, Canadian dollars.
Yeah, Canadian dollars. And English is spoken there.
Yes. And do you know the second official language of Canada?
Canada capital is Odisha.
No, it's Ottawa.
Mama.
Yes, ma'am, Ottawa.
Yes. Okay, so do you know the third language spoken in Canada? Anyone of you?
I'm French.
Spoken language is French, and the third is Punjabi.
Huh?
Yes, it's the third official language of Canada. Even you can see the banners over there written in Punjabi, even on the international airport.
Turns out... Ma'am.
Yes, because there are more number of sick people living over there. Yes.
Turns out that every language can be spoken in any country.
Yes, but I'm talking about the official language.
French is the official language.
Yes, English and French are the first and second official language. Okay, so I request you all my guests.
The second largest country in the world.
Yes. So do you know the first one?
Yes, ma'am. Russia.
Yes.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. So for tomorrow, I request all my guests to come up with amazing facts for the wildlife of the country. So okay. That was all about our today's event. We will meet you again tomorrow in this session, and we will visit Canada.
Okay, ma'am.
Hope you all have a good day. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am. Have